Hello, hello to everybody. I'm very excited to be here at the Corning Studio with my class. Thank you to all my audience here in the room, and thank you to the audience at home. What I'm doing is just a demo of the bead making, and this is a very interesting thing. We are going to use in this first, I will divide this lesson into demo. The first demo is bead making, and the second one will be blow beads. So, like the class we are doing is in two different session. Same, and now I'm going to make two different demos. So, this is I call this bead anemone, that you can appreciate that there are many, many stripes inside. It's really interesting. And I reached this point working with the filigree rods. Okay. Right now I pull before the rods by myself. It's just simple white inside, aquamarine outside, and clear. Okay, so we have to pull pretty thick guard of glass and pull by ourselves like a Murini. So this is the first step that we have to make. It looks like really, really sophisticated bead, but it's not. There is nothing so difficult. There are many steps that we have to make in proper way. So first, we have to pull our load, have to be the right size, okay? And after, we are going to cut our small slice of this load and put on the mandrel to pull more Murini thinning with all the stripe inside. But I think that I can explain the process doing, because it's much more interesting to see the work on fire. Okay, so just to remind you that all the questions are welcome. Okay, thank you. Fire. So, there are two different ways to pull the Murini with the filigree. We can cut before little slices like this to stick all together. Or, like I usually do, I just melt and I cut in the fire the rod. Okay? So, look at me. I use one mandrel like support. And I stick in the center, and now I just cut with the fire the first piece, and then I go with the second one. This color is very, very light. The result, it could be more nice if the road is a little bit darker, but we will see in the hand. Okay. So there is not a number of pieces of filigree that we have to add. It's really up to you. All right, again, now it's helpful for one tweezer. Okay, the last one here. Try to work always a little bit clean work. Try to keep everything in the right, properly nice way. Like I told you yesterday, there are many simple steps to do. As much steps there are, as much easier is to make the mistake. There are more opportunity to make the mistake. Okay, so I had a little bit, couple more of pieces like this. I think that we reach the goal. Okay, done. Now I warm and I heat everything. I'm marveling to obtain a nice cylinder. All right, good. Now I warm and rolled. Doesn't matter the color, but we use clear just to pull it.
And you try to keep the white marks nice and straight.
Yeah, exactly. You have to keep, after with the pulling, everything will be much more perfect. But now try to keep as much as possible straight. You know, even here on the sides is now is a little bit not perfect straight. But it will be pulling. And also, you know, we are making something organic. The result will be not, will be like the wave and the, under the ocean. So also it's interesting to see no perfect straight line. Now I keep the mandrel. Yesterday we saw that I, sometimes with a big garter, I just change the pointy with the glass. Now the blob is not so big, and then I can keep it, the mandrel. Heat very well the sides, heat the center. Always the same thing. We have to obtain the same color of all the garden. Have to be the same color, same density. We start a little bit with the push and pull, and controlling slowly. Don't twist, just keep straight. Use the gravity, and now we have to pull till we reach our own size, and it's the medium size, not too thin, not too thick. Windy, you remember to cool down. Okay. Now it's cooling the thin part, and I can keep pulling to use the thicker one here. Okay. And we have our Road of Murini by Filigrana. Try to don't put this on the cold bench. Keep on the hair. We find the spaces here where we can. All right, so it will go like this for a while. The pointing can crack, so it's better if we. Well, now we waited for a while that it cooled down, and then the next step is to cut in little pieces. I prepare here the small heater to preheat our small Murini. You know what, Anuka?
Yes.
I needed my help, Anuka, my angel. And I needed the light blue. Oh, no, here it is. Maybe this is not really blue, it's a turquoise, right?
Yes.
Can we find some light blue?
This one?
No, that's Pervinca.
More pale.
All right, it's thank you very much. Here, look. So, well, now we cut with the slice with the tool. We try to also to put in some is cracking here, the pointy. So, till I can hold it, I work with the pointy. Little box, maybe this. Yeah, almost the same size, eh? Not perfect, same size, but I'm a little bit shaking because holding from far away, the road is moving. And I cannot hold with the hand. Let me check first our first result, if it's okay. Okay, yeah, check the result. It doesn't cut. You have another one?
Yes.
Might be wonderful. Thank you very much. All right. Okay, we keep it this. Now they are still warm, so I go here and I keep everything warmer. I use the same background because the meaning is that the color of the background of the bead, now I'm going to make a cylinder, and on the cylinder I apply the small Murini, and the background looks like comes out. Okay, well, so now this is the mandrel. Just in case, Anuka, if I don't have enough Murini, we will cut some more, but just in case. The suggesting is just when you will try to work with this kind of bead, start with something small, because after we have to encase everything. Okay, here we are, the cylinder. Ready, a little bit lower, okay. Small flame. Keep warm all the bead, but don't melt yet the Murini. We keep the Murini solid till when we don't put all this, we fill all the spaces, all the surface. Okay, I warm everything a little bit. It is a patient work, eh? You have to work slowly.
So. Does it matter whether you have like taller ones in the middle or
just no, it's a, the natural effect of something can be taller, something smaller. It's very, that's very interesting. That's why you don't have to care too much. Perfect, the same size. Now, honestly, I'm working with a small one, a little bit on the border, because I'm going to make a round shape. So that's only the only one. But you will see there is a one magic moment when I'm melting that everything change and fit the size of the bead that we have it. We have it like a background. last loop. Okay. And there is a point now I make a little bit smooth flame, because we have to melt. This is a difficult, a little bit more. We have to melt everything in the same time. And the action is always the same that we saw all these days, that is a heating the sides, passing through the center. Little bit. We wait because now I mean needed some clear. It's interesting to put some transparent on the top of the Morini to keep close the effect. It doesn't spread. So. Also because sometimes the white come out and make a little bit dirty the bead outside. So we closed our Morini with a drop of glass. Well, done. Like I told you, we have to heat also between the Morini, not only the Morini. And there is a one moment that often the students say, please keep like this, it's wonderful. Stop, save like this. You know? Is it not? No, we go. And here we have done to melt all in once. We have to control the melting, otherwise we lose the control, and we don't have it. Now I'm using the gravity to shape a little bit. I don't touch at all with any tool the bead. I just turn and I come out hitting the right places. Out, use the gravity. Okay. Even there are some bubble, it's wonderful. It's that also the part of the atmosphere of the bead. So now I wait that it cool down just to show you the first effect. Now we are going to, you see, it's interesting already, but now we are going to cover everything with the clear. We saw yesterday how to encase the bead with a big drop, and I will use the same technique now, and after I will use also the my tool to give the shape. Melting, we go with this action, is not really the boring part of the process, is really interesting and important, the melting. We have to keep clean our glass, melting the base of the garden and keep warm the garden to the tip, back and forward. Okay, during this process of melting, we have to manage also the bead that have to be up at the flame where the heating rise, turning the bead back and forward. So now I'm going to melt a garter that have to be minimum the size of the bead. Now we reached the size of the bead. I hit very well the tip all around. I want to obtain the same color. All the glass have to be very, very liquid. And then I make a drop and I push the drop all over. All right. And now I hit immediately all the new layer of the glare, and then I use the plier to push off. And now usually I decide, in this moment I decide the shape. Now I push a little bit with the corner of my plier, I push down the nuclear to encase very well the sides. Immediately we can appreciate it much more with this layer of clear, the effect of the deepness and the anemone effect. Yeah, you know, is the glass is like the watercolor. If you add more clear, it's like when you add more water in the watercolor, it became lighter, of course. So that's why it's better to use a more deeper color. But in this case, I didn't put so thick level of clear, so the color didn't change so much. But affect a lot. We can see the lentil effect, and the pattern inside looks like much more big. I'm approaching to the melting on the hose very, very slow. I don't want to make a mess on near the hose, making. I really want to save after such long work. So I want to show you the effect of the beads. There too. Okay, so first part of the demo is gone with the one bead, the anemone bead. And now we can move a little bit with the blowing. What I'm doing is really, I start to work with the beads since the 95, 94, and after my experience with the lamp working, the figure and the shaping, I fall in love with the sounds of the beads in my hand. Using the beads of the other artists in Venice, I start to string my new jewelry. But I never found the color and the shape that I needed. So I decided, Davide, you are a lamp worker, why don't you make the bead by yourself? But you know that there is two different words, off mandrel and shaping, comparing with the bead making, it's are two different words. So I decided to start this adventure with the bead, with the support of my father-in-law, looking for, searching the tools of that age, you know, with the burner and so on. And one day, when after the first trying and with the traditional burner of the Venetian lamp worker and bead makers, I decided that it was not really. The temperature is 800 degrees, and the glass is always really solid. And so I went back to the my torch with the oxygen, and I decided to learn with the. And there was a pioneer, honestly, in that moment, of the bead maker. With the oxygen, with the torch. Well, so after this trip with like the bead making, I developed my own technique with my own pattern. And now I start to blow the bead in the 2005, and I'm adding my experience and my new technique to the beads, to the jewelry, to teach more, to give more new suggestion to my student, and this is what I'm going to show. It's really the traditional technique of the blowing, like in the art shop. So I'm going to use my baby pipe. It's a steel pipe. It's a wonderful only like object. I do like it. I have a different size. There are the small one, the medium, and the big, that sounds big, but really. And this is really the three sizes pipe. There is not a big difference, change just the fact that with the big one, there is a little bit big hole, and then you can hold and manage better the garden on the chip. After, we need also one nice small diamond scissor, because we are going to use the scissor like the in the furnace to make the neck of the work. I told you in the beginning when I arrived here with my introduction, with orientation of the class, that I'm changing. Before my classes were called blow beads class. Now what I'm going to introduce is just the blowing with the pipe. Is it really another word? You start, of course, with the bead making because it's a first step, clear glass, round shape. But if you learn to work with this technique, you can really make everything like an art shop. And I'm still learning to add more technique and more solution for this kind of work. Okay, so after this word, I want to show you a simple blow bead. And after, maybe you have time to make also another colorful one. Well, so to blow the bead, we don't need such big torch. It's helpful. But even with a small torch, with a regular concentrator, we can make our bead, the blow bead. For sure, with a big torch, with a big fire, we can melt more and we can keep warmer the garden. But after, when we blow, we cannot touch anymore with big fire. We need a soft fire. But we will see with the next days, and I will give you the right suggestion to go forward. Well, so now I use the clear. I want to be, I have to say something, but because for me it's very natural and obvious that I'm using soft glass. Even this is a clear, soft Effetre glass, so no borrow, with all the respect, but I come from Murano, and we use, sorry. Okay, now I will use the small one. So this is really a demo. You should wait till tomorrow morning for the class, okay? So. Always the same action, huh? Even here. And this is a sampled round bead, but this is magic. And still my favorite. It's a clear sampled round bead. Yeah, I close the hole. All right, now we have the grip over here. Thank you very much. We grip, give it a shot, and here is the bead. Okay, pass, check the bead. One more, no. Yeah, one more. Okay, now a little bit bigger, and I change the shape.
Davide, I really noticed the writing. When you do a hole on the other side, have you let it cool down?
Can you wait till tomorrow?
You're going to do it again, right? Okay, I'll watch harder than that. That was both right.
Show us something from that door. And this we leave here. So I think that now I can make something a little bit bigger for the show. All right. Wow. Standing. Yeah. Now I you know when you start to use the same thing and you feel it, it just I use all the day this every day, and even maybe there are other more that, but I feel it.
I'm sorry, this is the boring part. Okay. Can you clean this part, please? Anuka, everything. Thank you very much. Event.
Look at that.
And this is my question mark necklace. And I need this tool to grip. All right. Anybody of you want to try it on now?
Yeah.
No? Okay. So, tomorrow. I want to say thank you to everybody, to the organization of Corning Museum and Studio, to invite me, to give me the opportunity to stay here with this wonderful group, with the old staff, friendly staff. It was really a goal for me to be here, and I really appreciate the invitation, I appreciate the company. Thank you very much indeed, thank you.